Well, not even getting into do the ring introductions. It's an easy night for me, but not an easy night for Project 56, Joshua Dunbar, as he is in a number one contenders match against Sean Ricker, one half of Natural Selection. But you see him right there with a big clothesline and a nice back elbow taking out Ricker. This match, of course, is a result of the Great Goliath Battle Royal. Both men getting eliminated simultaneously, setting up what, in essence, was a draw, and now both men fighting out in singles competition. Sean Ricker, of course, from Baltimore, Maryland, and Josh Dunbar from your nearest bar.
And that's the thing. So Project 56, if Josh Dunbar just got the stands, if he really just got up and really put some effort into it, he'd have a shot at becoming the EWF champion. But I don't think he's going to do it tonight. My prediction, Richter will go over.
Well, we'll have to see about that. As you see the beautiful Bonnie Isle in the corner of Project 56, Joshua Dunbar. Dunbar went so far as to tell his partner, DK Murphy, stay in the back tonight. I mean, you were there when he told him, Kelly.
Oh, yeah. DK Murphy was stunned. You don't want me in your corner?
Oh, he said, no. I want to do this on my own. I want to do this to prove to everybody that I deserve to be here, and I deserve this shot against Sean Ricker. A lot of people saying that that he really doesn't, that he's not competition for Sean Ricker. What do you think about that, Kelly?
Oh, I agree. Sean Ricker is on a whole new level than Dunbar. I mean, I wonder how liquored up Dunbar had to get just to step in the ring right now.
I hear he's pretty drunk.
Like liquid courage.
Yeah, exactly.
And there again is my point. He needs to put the glass down, put the bottle down, and step it up. And then you'd have a shot at being the EWF champion.
We see Dunbar there with that key lock applied. And an interesting placement of it. He's got it put over the neck of Sean Ricker, as opposed to usually with the Kimura or the key lock, you put it behind the head, behind the back, so it torques not only the elbow but also the shoulder.
Oh!
And you see Sean Ricker with that big back elbow right across the jaw. And you don't see Josh Dunbar getting taken down with a back elbow that often, Kelly.
Yeah, he's a big guy. It takes a little bit of effort.
A big guy.
Look at a little too much for liquid courage tonight, if you know what I mean.
Well, look at Sean Ricker's not exactly a baby. I mean, he's no little fryer. The guy is huge.
I personally think Sean Ricker got ripped off last month. I think he won that rumble.
Well, you know, I've seen the footage, and honestly, quite frankly, I couldn't see who touched the who touched the ground first. I really couldn't make it out on my own. So, I mean, this really is the only way to do it. This is the only fair way to get this done tonight. You see Ricker coming off the ropes, ducking under that clothesline. Oh, big boot right to the stomach and drop down. DDT by Sean Ricker.
Makes an impact.
It's over. It's done.
Oh, not quite. Kelly, I gotta agree with you though. I mean, after that, I would have been done. A lot of men would have been done.
Okay, so this is what Ricker's gotta do. He hit him with that huge, huge DDT. Didn't quite get the three count, so now he's gonna wear him down.
Well, it's a smart thing to do. A big guy like Dunbar, you got to keep him on his feet. You got to get him tired. You got to wear him out. The longer this match goes, you got to believe that it goes in the favor of Sean Ricker, for the simple fact that Sean Ricker has the conditioning advantage over Josh Dunbar. I mean, Kelly, look at them.
Look at Sean Ricker.
Yeah,
I
know you are.
I will.
I'm talking about the conditioning, though, of Sean Ricker.
I'm enjoying it.
You hear the Hollywood sisters down there? What are they?
Yeah, they're enjoying it, too.
Who wouldn't?
Bonnie Isle.
She secretly loves it.
She's not really enjoying watching her man Dunbar getting beat in the corner. Big right hands there by Ricker. Oh, look at Ricker having to get drug out of the corner. Excuse me.
Well, that's what you do. He's got the advantage. Wait for the ref to step in. Don't just sit back and be a nice guy. You want to be the EWF champion, you got to take it to him.
Exactly, and this right here is the first stepping stone to doing so. This match again for the number one contendership, and Sean Ricker down by that big clothesline.
Ricker's got to get that regroup, and there you go. That's what I like to see. Big clothesline there.
Sean Ricker right there going for the cover on a Josh Dunbar. Hook of the outside leg.
Ooh, only two.
Wow.
Wow.
We got to give it to Dunbar here, Kelly. I mean, he's hanging in there.
Surprisingly. And you can see the frustration on Sean Ricker's face.
Well, he thought he was going to come in here and
be
done.
I'm sure he didn't think he had to work this hard.
And you see him with that reverse chin lock, that knee right in the middle of the shoulder blades, and he is just cranking back. Look at that.
Planting the kneecap right there, the ball right there in the middle of your knee. Planting right on the edge of the spine right there and just yanking back.
Well, Josh Dunbar able to turn his hips and get back to a vertical base. Now an elbow right in the stomach. Oh, and then a jawbreaker. Sending Ricker down to the mat with that clothesline, knocking him a little silly with that jawbreaker. Now back elbow there. Oh, and that Muay Thai clinch, the MMA background of Josh Dunbar. Front face lock applied. Looks like he's going for a suplex. Bonnie Isle very happy about what's going on. Oh!
No, I don't think she's happy about that.
No. I don't think Dunbar's happy about that either.
Oh!
I don't think Dunbar's happy at all right now. Dunbar on the ring apron. I mean, this is reminiscent to what we saw at the Great Goliath Battle Royal with both men on the apron, but this time Dunbar getting back into the ring.
And now on top of the ropes.
Oh! Now he's straddling the ropes.
Yeah, he's going to sit there for a minute.
Yeah, he is.
I can tell you from experience, that does not feel good.
No. Would you call that on the rocks? He got hit on the rocks? Can we say that?
No.
Okay. I thought it was funny. Now look at this. Sean Ricker has...
Ricker hits this and win.
Oh, you saw Ricker. Looked like he was going for a back suplex, excuse me, from the top rope. Instead, Dunbar able to knock him down. Whoa! Oh my God!
Unbelievable!
The agility of Sean Ricker leaping up to the top rope and then taking Josh Dunbar up and over with a suplex. Both men down after that big, big superplex.
Mike, what would happen here if we get another double countout?
Maybe a triple threat match?
Possibly.
Sean Ricker now able to roll over. There's a cover. Only getting a two count, though.
So close. So close.
Sean Ricker arguing with referee Christopher Lee.
You can see the frustration on Ricker's face. He hit that superplex. He thought he had it won.
It's over here.
Big right hand and a knee to the stomach. Reversal on that Irish whip. Now Ricker coming off the ropes.
Oh, ow.
Back body drop. Big back body drop right there. Sean Ricker in a bad way right now.
Ricker needs to regroup. Ricker needs to regroup.
Oh, definitely. And you see him in the corner right now, trying to gather himself. Look at that big knee. Now look at this scoop slam here coming up. Dunbar holding him up. Big power display. Taking him down. Oh, but look at this. He's too tired to even make the cover.
That might cost him the match. When you've got your opportunity to cover your opponent, you've got to capitalize on it. You can't sit back and take a breath.
Oh, well, you see Dunbar getting up and posturing to the crowd. But Kelly, that's a big mistake in my opinion.
Oh, how can it not? You need to be on top of Sean Ricker.
He's Sean Ricker back up to his feet now. And look at this, Dunbar. Oh, look at that. Ricker blocking essentially that STO. Wait a second, dropping him down. Crucifix pin. Whoa. Only two. Only a two count. Look at this, Ricker now. Oh! Ricker dropping him down with that Celtic cross. This might be it. Ladies and gentlemen, your winner of this match and the new number one contender for the EWF Championship, Sean Ricker! Well, Sean Ricker there with that Celtic Cross finisher getting the win over Project 56, Joshua Dunbar. And just like Nostradamus, he predicted it himself. He is the new number one contender for the EWF title.